today's topic is model an ER diagram using case study. So in the previous lecture we have discussed ER basics. In the other lecture we have also discussed degree of a relationship, how to represent it, and various types of it like unary relation, binary relation, ternary relation. We have also discussed mapping cardinalities, in which we have discussed one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, and many-to-many cardinalities. We also gone through relationship participation constraint, so in which we have discussed total participation and partial participation. So this is today's content. In this lecture, we will discuss how to model an ER diagram, what are the various steps and we need to follow them. And we will do it with the help of a case study. And we will also discuss some merits and demerits in ER modeling. And today we will summarize this complete topic. So let's start with steps in ER modeling. Our first step is to identify the entities. So these all the assumptions we will go through, and then we will identify what are the various entities. As we already know, sometimes we are referring in non-technical language like entities are nouns. So we can see here, a college contains many departments. So the first entity will be department. Each department can offer any number of courses. So the next entity can be course. Each course belongs to only one department. Many instructor can work in a department, so instructor is an entity. And instructor can work only in one department. Each department there is a head. So important thing to be noted here is head is not an entity. Head is a relationship, and we will go through further when we will discuss how to represent this relationship. An instructor can be head of only one department. Each instructor can take any number of courses. A course can be taken by any one instructor. A student can enroll for any number of courses. So the next entity will be student. Each course can have any number of students. So next step, find the relationships and cardinality. So first I will take all the assumption one by one, then we will find out the relationship. So let's start with, a student can enroll for any number of courses, and each course can have any number of students. Here you can see any is written over there. That means many courses can be there and many students can be there. So the relationship we will establish here is the course and the student entries will have the relation enrolled by. So the particular, if I take the one instance of this course, that instance can be enrolled by multiple student. And if I take the one instance of the student, that student can enroll many courses. So here we can simply see that the mapping cardinality is what? Many to many. Next one is each department can offer any number of courses, and each course belong to only one department. So here you can see each department can offer any number of courses. So this is directly many relation, and here each course belong to only one department. So this is one relation. So if I take one instance of the department, so this department can offer many courses, and if I take one instance of this course, then this course will be offered by only single department. So here we can see from this side, this is one to many relation, and from the side of course, this is many to one relation. Next one, many instructor can work in a department, and instructor can work only in one department. So department is having instructor, and we will see the relation. Many instructor can work in a department. So if I take the one instance of a department, that department can have many instructor. If I take the instructor instance, only a single instance of the instructor, then an instructor can work only in one department. So an instructor can have only one department. So that's why this is one to many relation. For each department there is a head, and instructor can be head of only one department. This is a very important relationship. Please focus on it. So each department there is a head. So there is a relationship between the department and instructor, because one of the instructor will be selected as the head of that particular department. So what we will do, department is headed by instructor. So the relationship is headed by. So if I take the one instance of the department, this department will be headed by only one instructor, and only one instructor can head only a single department. So this relationship is one to one relation. A course can be taken by only one instructor. each instructor can take any number of courses. So the relationship here is between course and the instructor. So course can be taken by only one instructor. So if I take the one instance of this course, that particular course can only be offered by only one instructor. If I take the instance of this instructor, this particular single instructor can offer many courses. So here we can see M here for representing many. So the relationship from the side of course is many to one. So the next step is to identify the key attribute. As I have already discussed in previous video lecture, what is key attribute? A particular attribute or a set of attribute which can uniquely identify a particular entity from the entity set. So here we will identify key attribute for every entity. So here I am considering department name is the key attribute for the department, and course ID is the attribute for course, a key attribute for course, and student number is the key attribute for the student, and instructor name is the key attribute for the instructor entity. So after this we will find out all the other relevant attribute in step number 4. So for department we are considering other attribute as a location, for course we are considering course name and duration and prerequisites, for instructor we are considering room number and telephone number, for student entity we are considering student name and date of birth of the student. So we are gathering all the information from all these processes. Now we need to integrate all the information, and we will represent all the information with the help of this ER diagram. So in this way we can completely understand these blocks are entities, and we can see these relationships in the diamonds, and we are having these ovals shapes which is representing attributes. So here we will start with course. So here we can see course offers by the department. Department is headed by some instructor. Courses is taught by some instructor. Courses are enrolled by the student, and these different entities have some attribute. All the key attribute are being represented with the help of underline. So here we can see department is having attributes like department name and location, and the key attribute for this department is department name. For course we can see here course name, duration, course ID, prerequisite attributes, and the key attribute is course ID. For student we can see the attributes like student ID, student name and date of birth, and the key attribute for this student is student ID. For instructor we can see here some attribute like instructor name, telephone number, room number, and this instructor name is the key attribute for the instructor entity. So this is how we can design different ER model. So try at yourself, try with different assumptions. You can find out various questions regarding ER modeling in your assignment which we have already uploaded on Moodle. So here you can see merits and demerits of ER modeling. What are the merits of ER modeling? It is very easy to understand. As I have discussed in starting, it is completely a non-technical design method. So a layman can easily understand without knowing what is that complete structure, like what is ellipses and what are the diamond shape and what are the blocks, and how to represent different entities. What is entity? Even if someone doesn't know about it, that is also helpful to understand. Then intuitive and helps in physical database creation. It is very intuitive, like you can easily understand the meaning of everything. And so physical database creation becomes very easy with the help of this ER diagram. Can help in database design. Give a high level description of the system, how it will look, and it just give a feel of the database. And what are the demerits? Physical design derived from ER model may have some amount of redundancy which may lead to inconsistency. Sometimes diagram may lead to misinterpretation if you are not aware well, because of limited information present in diagram as well. So today I am summarizing this complete topic. So we have also discussed various things about ER modeling. Let's discuss some summary. Miscommunication between the application user and the designer is the major source of error while we are creating some project or application. It is always better to represent business findings in terms of picture to avoid the miscommunication, so you can easily view the all the view whatever is going through. It is practically impossible to review the complete requirement document by business user. An ER model is one of the many ways to represent business finding in pictorial format. So this is one of the way to represent all the information. There are also another methods with the help of which you can view the application or your database design. ER modeling will also help the database design. ER modeling has some amount of inconsistency and anomalies associated with it. So thank you so much. If you are having any confusion, please ask me in comment. Thank you so much for your patience.